on Good Friday, the entire church fixes its gaze not just on the cross, but principally on Christ, who was nailed onto the cross, was lifted upon the cross, and who brought all things into fulfillment on the cross. The great irony of the Passion of Christ according to John is that in Jesus we see God's strength, splendor and triumph revealed amidst the pain and humiliation of crucifixion. Jesus progresses resolutely and expressively towards his hour, the hour of glorification on the cross. Rather than permitting Judas's kiss betray him, Jesus identifies himself and approaches those who came to arrest him. His statement, "I am," recalls God's self-designation to Israel. John's portrayal of Jesus as God in flesh endures even through his arrest, trial, crucifixion, and burial. Crucifixion is presented as a component of God's plan instead of a defeat which Jesus must overcome with the resurrection. Though in a silence-filled, grandeur-stripped ambience of Good Friday, one's emotions propel to mourn and weep, yet Jesus on the cross ceases to be identified as a tragic victim, instead emerges as a victorious hero and a sign. A victorious hero whose crystal-clear, purpose-driven life amidst continual discouragements and oppositions was never blurred or derailed, but anchoring on God accomplished the purpose. A sign that God is in full control of every situation, however brutal or tragic that might appear. That God is on the side of the oppressed. That God suffers with humanity. And that God's power will ultimately bring freedom and justice. To us who fix our gaze on Christ crucified through the Johannine Passion, Jesus teaches us from his purpose-driven life with a single-minded purpose to march ahead with God above us, with Christ before us, and with the Holy Spirit within us. From his silence before Pilate to refrain from uttering the wisdom of truth before people who, adhering to their personal agenda, are unwilling to give a listening ear. From his conviction with which he faced the Pharisees, Pilate, and soldiers, to prophetically acknowledge and establish the truth instead of falling prey to the ill-fated socio-political conspiracies. From his kind gesture of giving his beloved mother to the beloved disciple, to value the presence of our parents, friends, and significant others who act as catalysts and comfort us during our life's journey, especially during the grief-stricken moments, and to build lasting Christian relationships based on authentic discipleship. From the transformation he effected in the lives of Nicodemus and Joseph of Arimathea, who once came to Jesus in the dark and now openly come forward to claim his body, to be a source of transformation, to ward off fear from minds and heart, and bring people to the light. Today, when people are busy with clicking the best of photos with best poses and filters possible, or drafting the resume with carefully chosen words so as to create an inspiring and attractive identity, here is Jesus at his best, a real victorious hero and a sign. Let our gaze be on Christ crucified. He has something to teach us today.